talked about today in the perspective of information technology, because I see there are a lot of participants here from that field, issues like interoperability, open access, these sort of words that are going around. These public policy concerns are very important. And so I would say to you that this is a broad policy issue that is not specific to ICT, information technology. And sometimes in some of the recent arguments and debates we've had about intellectual property and patents and standards, we've had a huge amount of lobbying and political activity related to information technology aspects of it. But this is a far broader issue than that. The Commission's communication on standards will cover standards in every conceivable field, in services and in products, and could also include things, for example, like social standards, in terms of social standards in manufacturing, standards for how employees are treated, standards for corporate social responsibility. And those things are really important in terms of trade issues as well, where people are saying, if they're buying products from a third world country, how can we be sure that these products are made to appropriate standards, that child labour isn't being used, that people aren't being exploited, and so on. And I think clearly standards have a role there. So the public policy interest of standards is evident, and that will now rise up the agenda and will be discussed in the autumn. I mean, what are the issues then to look forward? I think, first of all, that it's just important to remember, and this was something that came out from obviously from the WTO last week, because the WTO also, in terms of looking at trade issues, has, is well aware of the potential for standards to close markets as well as to open markets. And they have clear criteria about standards development: openness, consensus, balance, and transparency. And that, I think, is the basic criteria that, in terms of public policy interest in recognising standards, have to be firmly on the table all the time. And that's, of course, is the role of the recognised standards bodies, which, where their charters, their governance, essentially ensure or should enshrine those activities. The real question, I think, and one that will be addressed cogently by the Commission, of course, is in terms of consensus and openness. It may well be clear that industries or experts involved in a particular field around the table are involved in that process. But what about consumers or users? What about small enterprises, which characteristically don't have the resources to send people to participate in standardisation discussions? Do we need to provide some means of ensuring that SMEs are fully engaged and consulted in that process? Secondly, I think, is in terms of the public policy issues. So there's the process itself. Secondly, is the role of European Union or governments in setting some policy directions, in starting off processes. If you like, mentoring the development of standards, but also providing some urgency to the process. I think what's interesting about this way to promote and develop standards, in this case, that are completely universal to keeping the World Wide Web moving forward. And we need to find a way of recognising and building those into the standards process, because they are extremely important. In fact, arguably the whole of the World Wide Web Consortium's work has been absolutely crucial in making the internet work. And that's not perhaps given the visibility that you should do. So the development of those essentially royalty-free standards in that case are absolutely crucial. So we have to allow the market to work to develop those. Also, there is a major crossover between standards and public markets and public procurement, which is, I know, a particular interest of Maastricht University as well. Now, public procurement, in my view, is one of the most unexploited public policy tools that we have within the single market. We could be doing far more with public procurement and making it more effective and generating more jobs and encouraging more innovation. And particularly on public procurement of IT, I think clearly issues about interoperability and standards are going to be far more crucial in the future than they are now. I think we're going to see a move away from very large-scale procurement of systems, which history has shown take far too long to do. There are always really big arguments among the commissioners of those systems within public administrations. So by the time the contract is finished, the technology has moved on. But we're going to see many more devolved system developments. But the really important thing is that they will interoperate with each other. So, for example, in a health service, that different regions may develop and invest in different systems, different new technology tools, but then they're available for other health groupings in other parts of that country or indeed across Europe to use, because we've agreed a set of common operating standards and principles. I think that's going to be extremely important in the future. The open source, in terms of software where the codes are open, where people are essentially, the user community is developing those, and those are becoming more important also. I mean, it clearly will coexist with other types of proprietary standards, because there may be users who don't feel they have the competence or the capability to do that. And why should we deny them access one or the other? And indeed, there are plenty of cases of proprietary systems running on open source platforms. So again, you have that coexistence. So I think that the real issue for public policymakers is to allow the standards process to continue to develop, because it's crucial to the future of a modern economy. It's helpful to consumers. It's helpful to society. About the standardisation process is, of course, it can take a very long time, because the need to reach consensus can often be very difficult. And if there's no timetable, no political oversight, and no push to move forward, then the process can often get stuck. It's interesting, for example, if you look at the global motor vehicle standards. The global process has been in place since 1998, where for the first time we've actually been looking at, in a major industrial commodity, and this, by the way, includes all motor vehicles, including trucks, buses, motorbikes, and cars, but to try and agree some sort of global consensus. Because in motor vehicle standards, as in other global issues, some of the public interest criteria are absolutely clear. For example, we want to make cars do less damage to pedestrians in low-speed collisions. That's been a policy imperative for Europe, where we have much more crowded streets than in America, for example. But because that's an evolving new technology, then it's sensible to try and reach a global agreement on that. But it's taking quite a long time to do that. And similarly, as new technologies are moving forward. I mean, things like trucks, for example, where we now have an increasingly global market, it clearly makes sense to deal with things like exhaust emissions, so that truck manufacturers can invest in one basic technology. I mean, in terms of the public interest, I think that provided the standards are low enough, the public is not interested about the test standards are used to apply those. These are actually issues that historically have developed among specialists in different administrations. And I think it's perfectly reasonable for politicians to say to administrators, why can't you agree on a common standard? Why can't we, when we crash a car, crash that into the same barrier at the same speed, instead of having different standards? The amount of cost that industry spends on meeting conflicting standards is probably billions of euros across the world, simply to satisfy different types of administrators. Or isn't it actually better to spend that into making safer products and better products? So, you know, there are real public interest questions here at a global level, which I think standards will bring to the fore.